The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 18, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 23rd of November 1972 in Hyderabad, India.
Krishna is the supreme whole, and we are His parts and parcels, therefore our duty is to serve Him. This is our constitutional position. Jiver sarup hai nitya Krishna das. We cannot become Krishna. We are eternally Krishna's servitors, part and parcel. This is real conclusion. Qualitatively one. Just like this finger, you can call it body, but it is part and parcel of the body. Similarly, the part and parcel of the Supreme Lord, you may call God, but He is not the Supreme God. Supreme God is Krishna. Ishara Parama Krishna Satchidananda Vigraha. So, anasina apramiyas, anasina, it cannot be destroyed. Although it is very minute, apramiyas, you cannot measure. You have no such measuring method that you can measure the soul's length and breadth. In geometry, they finish it, the point has no length and breadth. But that is not the fact. Point has also length and breadth, but we cannot measure it. Apramaya. Similarly, there is length and breadth of the soul also. That is also mentioned in the Vedic literature. It is said in the Puranas, Kesagra Satavadasya Satadha Kalpitasya Cha Jiva Bhaga Savigyaya Sa Anantaya Kalpate. The spirit soul is measured, first of all, divide the tip of your hair into 100 parts, and then take one part again, and again divide it into 100 parts. That portion is the measurement of the soul. Or in other words, 1/10,000 part of the tip of your hair. Because we have no measuring instrument, although the soul is there within this body, we cannot find it out. Although the soul and the super soul both are situated within the heart, and the heart is the center of all vitality, energy of this body, that is accepted, but we have no eyes to see the soul or the super soul, because these material eyes are blunt, imperfect. You cannot see so many things. You have to purify your senses. Then you can see. Atas Sri Krishna Navadi Navhave Grayam Indriyai. The present blunt senses, material senses, all are imperfect. Even we hear the Lord's name, Namadi, Atas Sri Krishna Namadi. Just like we are chanting, one who is spiritually advanced, he is enjoying this Hare Krishna, Krishna's name. But those who are blind, they will see, they will think what these people are chanting, because he has no power to hear. But realization of Sri Krishna begins by hearing. That is the method. Savanam Kirtanam Vishnu. If you hear about Krishna, if you chant about Krishna, then gradually your heart will be cleansed. Chito Dharpana Marjanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nidvapanam. By chanting and hearing, the dirty things within the heart will be cleansed, then you will understand what is your position in relationship with God. You will understand what is God. Therefore, in this age especially, Kali Yuga, because people cannot perform any other austerities, they are unable, they are so dull. Manda sumanna matayo manda bhagya jupadita. This is the position of the people of this age. Prayena alpayayusa. Generally, their span of life is very short. It is decreasing day by day. As our forefathers lived 90 years, 100 years, now we are not living up to such extent of ages. But gradually it is decreasing, and it will decrease to such a point that if a man lives for 20 to 30 years, then he will be considered as grand old man. That day will come. So this age, therefore Shastra says, prayena alpayus. Generally, almost everyone is short-lived. Prayena alpayus, kalau asmin yuge jana, asmin yuge kalau. They are very short-lived. Then again, mandya, all rascals, mandya, third class, no first class men, practically no brahminical qualification, all sudra qualification. Therefore, mandya, sumanna matayo. And if one comes forward to be spiritually enlightened, he accepts something bogus without any reference to the shastras. Therefore, mandya sumanna matayo. They have got an opinion and that is going on. You may have any opinion, that is all right. This foolishness is going on in this age. Mandya sumanna matayo. Manda bhagya. And most unfortunate. Everyone is practically unfortunate. Nobody has certainty what he will eat tomorrow or in the evening. Everywhere, don't think only it is in India. In America, when I went there, I thought everyone is very rich. There are so many poor men. They are lying on the street. The street-lying population is everywhere. Either in India or in America or in England, I have seen. The first class, second class, third class man will remain there. You may have a try to make everyone first class. The division, first class, second class, third class will go. That is nature's arrangement. Manda sumanda matayo manda bhagya jupadrita and disturb. That's like today is strike. Unnecessary. Disturbance. So many disturbance everywhere, all over the world. Because the population has degraded. They must be like that. This is the way. Therefore, anyone is interested for spiritual advancement, he should take to this Krishna consciousness movement, which is principally chanting Hare Nama, Hare Nama, Hare Nama Iva Kivalam. Kalo Nastiva, Nastiva, Nastiva Gati Dandatha. In this age, you cannot practice yoga, mystic yoga practice, meditation. It is not possible. It is very difficult. You cannot arrange for big, big sacrifices. That is also not possible. Therefore, three times it is said, Nastiva, Nastiva. You cannot take to the yogic principle, you cannot take to the ritualistic ceremonies, you cannot take to the temple worship also. It is very difficult. Titeja dhyato Vishnu, titayang jajato makhai, dhapare parichajyayang kalau tat harikirtanat. This is the injunction of the Shastra. That in the Satyayuga, when people used to live for 100,000 of years, at that time, yogic principle meditation was possible. And in the Treta Yuga, the performance of big, big sacrifices was possible. because things were available. There were Jagik Brahmins. In this age, practically, there is no Jagik Brahman who can perform yoga, no competent Brahman. Therefore, performance of sacrifices is not possible. The only performance of sacrifice is this, as you are performing, Hare Krishna festival. That is stated, Jagai Sankirtanai Prayai Jajanti Hi Sumedasa. Jagai Sankirtanai. In this age, Kali Yuga, no other sacrifices is possible. Only sacrifice, this is sacrifice. Jagai Sankirtanai, that's why we are doing in a small scale. But it can be done in large scale. But people are not interested. They have lost all brain, sumedhasa and alpamedhasa. These two words are used in this art. Alpamedhasa, medha means brain substance. So those who are alpamedhasa, they means less brain substance. Antavattu phalam tesam tad bhavati alpamedhasa. Alpamedhasa, less intelligence, less brain substance. They worship different demigods. Kāvastastha hitajñāna jajante annadevata. The annadevatas are there, but who are attracted to worship other demigods? Those who are lusty. Kāvastastha hitajñāna. Those who are lusty, and being lusty, they have lost their senses. Hitajñāna. Śrīla Viśvanātha Chakravarti Thakurji says, hitajñāna, nasta buddhaya, no intelligence. Kāmastastha hitajñāna, jajante anna devata, antavattu phalam tesam tad bhavati alpamedhasa. So, in this age, this is simply waste of time. If you actually interested in spiritual advancement of life, if you divert your attention in so-called worship of this demigod, that demigod, this demigod, then you will simply waste your time. There will be no advancement. And even you become perfect in worshipping the demigod, then what will be your profit? The profit will be Janti Deva Bhata Devan. You can go to the planets where the demigods live. But the planets and this material world, everything will be annihilated. Antavattu phalam tesam. Suppose you are promoted to the Brahmaloka. That is also antavattu. It will be finished. Because by the end of Brahma's duration of life, everything within this universe will be finished. Therefore, antavattu. That is not permanent. But if you manage to go back to home, back to Godhead, then jadgatyana nivartanti tad dhama param. That is perfect life. So anyone who is not interested in perfect life, they will be allured by this so-called demigod worship. But one who is sumedhasa, sumedha, one who has got good brain, substance, for him, in this age, it is recommended, jagai saṅkītanai prāyai jajanti hi sumedhas. Krishna varna, Krishna himself, Krishna or Krishnam varnayati, the one, the incarnation of God, who will chant always Krishna. That is Chaitanya Mahāprabhu. Chaitanya Mahāprabhu preached this Hare Krishna mantra. Kandatva kotika maniya. Krishna, although he is black, he is attractive more than millions of people. Kandatva kotika maniya visesa sobham govindamadi purusam tamahamaya. So, anyway, Krishna appears in four colors, red, black, yellow and white, in different ages. So, in this age, Kali Yuga, Krishna appears as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, yellow color. Krishna Varnam, Tisha Akrishnam, Akrishna may be red, Akrishna may be white, but this Akrishna means pita, yellow. Because other Akrishna, red and white, was in the Satya Yuga and Treta Yuga. Therefore, here Akrishna means the yellow. Krishna Varnam Tisa Krishna Sanga Panga Astra Parsadam is always surrounded by his intimate devotees. He is surrounded by many devotees. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, wherever he was going, thousands and thousands of people were following his Sankirtan. But especially, he was always surrounded by five special devotees. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, Sri Advaita Gadadhar Sivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinoda. He is himself Sri Krishna Chaitanya, his expansion Nityananda, his incarnation Sri Advaita Prabhu, his internal energy Gadadhar and his external marginal energy Advaita Prabhu as Shiva. But he has got another energy which is called external energy. External energy cannot come in front of God, Krishna. This is Maya. Just like darkness cannot come in front of the sun. Krishna Surya Sama Maya Andhakar. Jaha Krishna Taha Nai Maya Rodhika. This material world is dark. It is called Tama. Tamasi Ma Jyotirgava. The Vedic instruction is don't remain in this material world. Come to the spiritual world. Spiritual world. Dasya Prabha Prabhavato Jagadanna Koti. Kotisu Asesa Vasudhadi Vibhuti Vinnam Tad Brahma Niskalamanantam Asesa Bhutam. So, come to the Brahma platform, Brahma Jyoti. Don't remain within this darkness. So therefore, in this age, Krishna Varnam Tisa Krishnam Sangha Pangasa Parsadam Jagai Sankirtanai Prayai Jajanti Hi Sumedha. This is intelligence. To chant Sankirtan, Bhavi Militva Kirtayati. We are assembling in big assembly, just like we are trying to introduce. It is very easy. Chant. Thousands and thousands of people, never mind what he is. It doesn't matter whether he is learned or poor, rich or poor, or black or white, or Brahman or Sudra. No consideration. Come together. Chant Hare Krishna Mantra. Jagai Sankirtanai Prayai. Jajanti Hi Sumedhas. Your brain will be cleansed. It is so easy. It is so nice and so perfect according to the instruction of the Veda. Harinnama, harinnama, harinnama iva kevalam. Repeatedly, in every Vedic literature and practically, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu introduced practically. And he asked every Indian to go outside India and preach this called Hare Krishna Mantra. But we are not doing that. We are going outside our country to beg only, not to give. And here is a prime gift you can give all over the world. Your country will be glorified. There are answers for this. Prithivite ase jato nagaradigram. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's prediction. As many towns and villages are there on the surface of the globe, everywhere this Hare Krishna mantra, Lord Chaitanya's name, will be celebrated. That is being done. There is immense field for introducing this Hare Krishna cult all over the world. That is practical. Unfortunately, although Chaitanya Mahaprabhu entrusted the matter to every Indian, not that to the Bengalis, because he appeared in Bengal, he never said for the Bengalis. He said, Bharat Bhumite Manusya Janma Hoilo Jat. On this holy land of Bharatvarsha, anyone who has taken his birth as a human being, he should make his life perfect. Janma Sarthak Kori. You cannot preach without making your life, first of all, perfect. If I remain imperfect, I cannot preach. One must be perfect. That is not very difficult. We have got direction of great sages and saintly persons and God Krishna Himself. So, to make our life perfect is not at all difficult. We are simply neglecting. That is our misfortune. Mandasa manda matayo manda bhagya. Because we are manda mata, we are accessing some bogus logic, bogus ism, and wasting our time. We should take from this asana the real path. Then we shall become intelligent. Sumedhasa. Jagai sankirtanai prayai jajanti hi sumedhasa. This shortcut method. Intelligent class of man will take this sankirtan movement for his spiritual elevation of life. It is a fact. It is scientific. It is authorized. So, don't neglect. Take this chanting of Hare Krishna, heart and soul. And anywhere. Niyamitas marane natala. There is no rules and regulation that you have to chant at this time, at that time, in this position, at that position. No. Because it is especially meant for this fallen conditioned soul. There is no hard and fast rule. Nam nam kari bahuda nijasadva shakti tatprakita niyamita smarane nakal. The name, the holy name of Krishna is as powerful as Krishna. There is no difference with Krishna and his name. Krishna is absolute. Therefore, there is no distinction between Krishna's name, Krishna's form, Krishna's quality, Krishna's entourage, Krishna's pastime from Krishna. Everything is Krishna. If you hear about Krishna, then you should know that you are touching Krishna by oral deception. If you see Krishna, the deity, that means you are seeing personally Krishna. This Krishna is absolute. He can accept your service anyway, because He is everything. Isavasanidam sarvam. He is energy. Parasya brahmana shakti sarvidam akhilam jagat. Everything Krishna is energy. So, if we are in touch with Krishna's energy, with little knowledge, we are direct in touch with Krishna. This is the process. As you become constantly in touch with Krishna, that is Krishna consciousness, then you become purified. Purified. Just like if you put one iron rod in the fire, it becomes warmer, and at last it becomes red hot. When it is red hot, it is fire. It is no more iron rod. Similarly, if you keep always in Krishna consciousness, you become Krishnaized. This is the process. Then everything becomes purified. Then your spiritual life is manifested. Then your life is successful. So, the first beginning is, as it is said by Krishna, antavattvimedeha. Don't be attached with this body. The body is material. But even this body is material. It can be spiritualized by the same process, by Krishna consciousness. Spiritualized means when this body will forget the materialistic activities. This body you can utilize for sense gratification. That generally people are doing. Eating, sleeping, mating, and drinking, and so on. So you can utilize this body, that is material. But if you engage this body for the service of the Lord, it becomes spiritualized. As I have already explained, the iron rod, constantly in touch with fire, it becomes, at end, it becomes red hot. That is fire. At that time, it acts as fire. You touch that red hot iron rod anywhere, it will burn. Similarly, this body can be spiritualized, although it is material body. How? Sevan mukhi hi jivhado same vaspuratada malchabhya vicharini bhakti jogena ja sevate sagunan samati toi etal brahma bhuya kalpat. Brahma. Brahma bhuya kalpat, it at once becomes Brahma. Brahma Bhuyaya Kalpita. How? Abhyavicharini Bhakti Yogena Jasebat. Therefore, this process, Archa, everyone is engaged only in Krishna's service. They are from the beginning of the day, 4 o'clock, they rise from the bed. They offer Mangalarutri. You are seeing practically. We are demonstrating the Krishna consciousness. How one can become Krishna conscious perfectly? Therefore, we have brought this deity. Anyone can do it at home. Where is the difficulty? If these Europeans and Americans, they can do, our Indians, which is our heritage. We are born in this land of hard work, we cannot do it. But we are neglecting. We are so fallen. Mandam, sumandamatayo, mandabhagya. We have become so unfortunate that we cannot take to this process. So, whatever we have done, that's all right. But now, this Krishna consciousness movement is there. Everyone should take it very seriously and make his life perfect. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
That Krishna is in every living entity. Therefore, they say that by serving humanity and your fellow man, that is serving Krishna. Is that correct?
See, if you remain in a room to serve the room, does it mean they are serving you? You are within a room. So simply cleansing the room, does it mean serving you? The present moment, what they are doing? Just like my Guru Maharaj used to say, a man has fallen on the water and one brave man came. He said that I shall save this man. And he also jumped in the water and brought his coat and shirt. And he said, now the man is saved. Is it saving the man? So similarly, the service of humanity means they are serving the body. Where is the soul? They do not know how to serve. Just like washing the cage and the bird within the cage is starving. So they do not know what is service. Jasyatma-buddhi kunapeti dhatuke. They are thinking this body, that is we are explaining this morning, antavattvi mediha. This body is perishable, it is material. What is the use of serving it? However you serve it, it will destroy. Try to save the soul who is put into this body and embarrassed. That is real service. This is Krishna consciousness movement. We are trying to save the soul. The body, however you try to save it, it will antavattva inidiha. It will end. Today or tomorrow or after some years. You cannot save it. Save the soul. Nitya satta sharirina. The sharirina, the soul, which is within the body, that is nitya, eternal. Now, although it is nitya, it is fallen in certain condition of this material body, that it appears to be dying. Janma mrityu charabhyadhi dukkha dosha anudarshanam. He is under the tribulation of birth, death, old age and disease on account of this material body. Therefore, if you actually want to give service to the humanity, then give service to the soul. And if you give service to the soul, automatically the body is also served. But if you stress on the body without effort, despite all arrangements for humanitarian work, the human society becoming worse and worse. Why? That is not service. They do not know how to serve. Illusion. Real service is this, Krishna consciousness. See? So, make him aroused in relationship with Krishna. That is real service. So what is going on in the name of service, that is not service. That is simply washing the coat and shirt. That's all. Hare Krishna.